As the climate changes, wildlife, plants, and birds will need cooler, wetter, safe havens to live and breed. The Upper Columbia River Basin in BC is one of those places. Caribou need deep snow to reach lichen to eat. Wolverines need deep snow to den. Salmon need cold waters. And all of these animals need connected ecosystems to roam freely. Research shows large linked landscapes are our best opportunity to provide for this critical movement. Fortunately, the Upper Columbia, known for its steep terrain, cold winters, and wet forests, offers this type of climate refuge. These amazing natural features that draw people to the area are also what makes the region a refuge for all kinds of species, resilient to climate change. Rising temperatures due to past, present, and future greenhouse gas emissions are projected to continue to rise in the coming decades, affecting snowpack and glacial landscapes.
The Canadian portion of the Columbia Basin, I think we're only about 15% of the total basin, but we supply 30% of the water. And that's partly because these cool, wet environments and the high snowfall, and combined with glaciers, are storing water through the winter and then release them later in the summer and into the fall. So in terms of streams and aquatic environments, having that storage, natural storage, into the late summer is extremely important.
But research and climate modeling show temperature, rain, and snowfall may be more stable here than in most other places. Climate refuges can trap carbon. Conserving the area as a stronghold will be beneficial to people, wildlife, and plants in the future. BC's biodiversity depends in large part on old-growth forests. These high-productivity forests in the Upper Columbia are globally rare and play critical ecological roles.
The Upper Columbia, because it is the wettest part of the interior rainforest, we have very large trees in these forests, and they've been undisturbed in some cases for a millennia based on looking at lichen studies. Even though the trees may not be 1,000 years old, the stands have been undisturbed for that long, so they've accumulated carbon over a very long period of time. And if we can maintain those trees on the land base and not harvest them or allow them to burn, they end up being sequestering tremendous amounts of carbon.
Functioning old-growth forests are home to many important, endangered, irreplaceable species. But they are also special to people as places of connection and adventure. Indigenous communities across the region are working to protect habitat for caribou, which means intact old-growth forests and important valley bottoms. Climate refuges, like the Upper Columbia, are critical places for vulnerable species to more easily adapt to the effects of climate change on the horizon. Our vision for this region is a fully functioning and flourishing ecosystem. Y2Y's mission is to connect and protect sensitive, important areas such as headwaters, gravel bed rivers, and climate refuges, so wildlife can thrive and people can continue to connect with the landscapes they know and love. You are part of the solution. Visit y2y.net/UpperColumbia to learn more.